Hey, reckoners, and welcome back to the Chameleon Creator. So, last time we spoke, we had obtained that bookmark, which functions as a key to the library. I could not figure out how to use it as an actual bookmark, so we are here at the first decision. Last time we chose Forget About It, which set us on that friggin' lovely road of episode 2. So we're gonna choose Keep Looking Into the Town. We saw this in episode 1, so I'm gonna fast forward. And now, last time, we chose Keep Your Eyes on the Shifter. I believe this leads to one more decision, but I'm gonna choose Forget About It. And if it leads to episode 2 again, we shall immediately restart and choose the other option. So, after squinting for an embarrassing amount of time, Elora gave up, realizing that squinting didn't help improve her eyesight at all, despite certain people saying otherwise. By the time she realized this, the shifter that she was curious about was suddenly nowhere to be seen.
Seriously?
Her eyes darted all over the kingdom, but she couldn't spot the figure anywhere. She took her eyes... Oh wait, remember that typo, that's a typo we've seen before. Oh, I see, that was the same. This is a new part.
Oh well, forget about it.
It was annoying, but her curiosity of the shifter disappeared almost as quickly as the shifter itself did. Wait. Did that really just come out of her mouth?
Forget about it.
Much better. Looks like in a fit of annoyance, she accidentally discovered another thing she seemed to have inherited from her dad. A really weird accent slips out of her mouth from time to time, which she occasionally calls his Big Apple accent, whatever that means. I see. Elora swore to herself that she would never let her dad find out about this moment for as long as she lives. Getting her fill of the scenery, Elora let the upper half of her body droop further down onto the railing, looking like a towel that's been hanged out to dry. So, this is the same so far, isn't it? Hoping the scenery would be distracting enough for her to figure out it, maybe worse. It's all because of the dumb cake and her dumb dad. We're in line, dumb. Yeah, this is the same. We may have to persist. Maybe what should happen is we persist looking after the shifter, but don't go as far as trying to climb onto the tree. Maybe that's the key thing that hinges here. Yeah, let's fast forward, see what happens. It's gonna be all scary. Yep, door, darkness. Yep, evil chair. Darkness, creaky, creaky, big. Lumpy bad guy. Yeah, that's just a bundle of delight that we all wanted to experience again, isn't it? Good God. Story ended. It's nothing I wanted, indeed. Okay, give me a bookmark, right? Right? No. I was hoping it would give the bookmark text again. And it probably did, and I probably clicked through it too fast to read. But I did not see it. So let's start. Skip through the story. You know, the dad reading the story to the girl complaining, yada yada yada. And we'll choose look out the window. We'll choose keep looking. I should really just paint a bookmark, I guess. I should make use of the bookmark system. They give you a freaking buttload of bookmark spots, and I don't know why. I guess for certain moments. That too fast food sequence. Oh, there's a back button. I forgot about that. Okay, so keep looking into town. Boom. Keep your eyes on that shifter. And then there should be another decision. Right. Fast for the next decision. Okay, there we go. We didn't learn a lesson. Now, we have learned our lesson very hard. Elora somehow learned her lesson from her previous curiosity and turned away from the attention-grabbing shiny in the garden, knowing full well that something far more important demands her attention. Could this be the super rare character development that Elora has heard so much about? She's always tried to buy one at the store, but every time they're in stock, they're gone before she even steps foot outside of her home. She's heard that people line up for weeks just to get their hands on one. Could she have truly been blessed with such an honor? She's totally gonna sell it for double the profit later. That's a good grin. Getting her fill of the scenery, Elora let the upper half of her body droop for the night like a towel time of dry. And she hung there, my good kid, over words, just to kind of press new after all. She was hoping this would be protecting, blah, 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 blah. So this is the same again. But I'm pretty sure that is the hinging decision. I'm pretty sure if we don't learn our lesson, we end up flying over the rail. So something different has to happen at some point. This is her deciding she has to go look for the cake, right, to taste it ahead of time. Yes, the issue being, Elora was a terrible liar, indeed, find the cake the first time, right, that makes sense to me. Sneak cake, yes, okay. Right, I mean, I forget, this is all shaping up the same way so far. Which is not good, because I'm not sure what decisions I haven't exhausted yet. Operation Prevent Cake Heartbreak, indeed. Maybe things will just happen differently, because I'm 10 minutes behind or whatever. Actually, I don't remember what the clock said last time. That's the same mirror. She be guess the kind of person you are. Guess Canary's right, that's just the kind of person you are. Yes. There's no way for me to incrementally step. Maybe I can hit the rewind button. I don't know what the heart does. That's a book. I don't know what these buttons do. I should test them out, probably. With the smart decision to do. Head towards the door. So I'm hoping what'll happen is that when we get... Elora's room is a fair... Yes, indeed. So let's check it out. Connect to the rest of the castle. The hallway. Neither were very good having conversations. Right. So walk down the hallway. It's very scary. Indeed it is. The door to the recreational hall. Don't go in the recreational hall. No, don't do it. Okay, this... I'm hoping something different happens here. Oh, there's red stains again. Dang it. This is the same. This is the Goram same. I'm gonna fast forward. If it's different, I'll replay it through it slower. Yeah, this is the exact same. Maybe we have seen all the endings. I know the spook dude said third time's the charm and all, but you shouldn't take the words of a guy whose head isn't even connected to his mouth so literally. So really, why do you keep coming back? Are you expecting me to give you something else? Was the bookmark not enough? You cleaned your teeth with it, and you even unlocked a library door with it. That bookmark was made of friggin' paper. Just imagine all the things you could be accomplishing if you were able to do all the things with a paper bookmark. And yet here you are. I have nothing else for you besides my rising temper, so please don't come back until the rest of the story is ready. And if you do, then I'll have no choice but to unleash my secret technique. It's been passed down my kind for generations, and believe me, you don't want any of that, so show yourself the door. I know it's hard to see considering how dark it is and all, but trust me, it's there. Okay, so that was the same ending-ish, but apparently I probably missed some differences from that person's voice last time. They reiterated that we have the bookmark which we used to access this library, which has these three characters. But. Dang it. Sorry, I didn't mean the characters. I'm gonna hit back again. But. The menu has this clear bookmarks button, but it is full of empty slots. They're all empty. So the bookmark we got is not functional as a bookmark, right? We can reach an agreement on the fact that I'm not being insane, that the bookmark does not function as a bookmark. As far as we can deduce, the bookmark's only function is to unlock the library. So, the only course of action that occurs to me now is to go to the end again, the same end, the same vile ending, and experience the secret technique. But I will try, at this second, I will choose the not learn a lesson one to make sure that that only leads to the falling out of the tokenomics ending. Because if there's a decision beyond that, that would be what I'm missing. Okay, what does this button do? This button does bookmarks, right? Empty slots all around, right? This button does preferences. Okay, we don't need to be concerned ourselves with... Oh, after choices, skipping... mess with this. No, I'm not gonna mess with that right now. So, fast forward to the first decision. This is episode 2. This decision, where we now choose to keep looking, forget about it, definitely leads to the ending with possible secret technique, so keep looking. Forget about it, definitely leads to the bad ending, so we're gonna keep your eyes on the shifter. Learning our lesson definitely leads to the bad ending, so we haven't learned our lesson. Aha! Aha! There is one more decision. Now I can't forget to check out the secret technique. I need to remember to come back and hit the bad ending again to witness a secret technique. But we are now, last time we wiggled our way down there, we are now too hipster for this nonsense. Just kidding, she's totally over that hip wiggling fad.
Hip wiggling? That's so 2 months ago. Sorry, Shiny, but there's no way I'm gonna get caught doing it with a poser like you. I was wiggling hips before it was cool, so I can tell you're one of those people who started doing it because it got popular. Way to ruin hip wiggling for the real fans. Bunk.
Absolutely disgusting. Elora lost all interest in the Shiny. The Shiny, in return, seemed to have realized this and let off one final sparkle of sadness before stopping for good. Knowing that her slipper touched such a gross fad follower, she didn't even want to go down and retrieve it anymore. She'll just buy a new pair with the birthday money she's gonna get. And with the rest of the money, she'll probably buy a nice sweater vest, a pair of glasses, and probably a grand caramel macchiato. Iced. Cause she's a hipster. Getting her fill of the scenery, Elora let the upper half of her body droop further down on the railing, looking like a towel. Oh crap. It's repeating again! Oh no! Oh no! Do I dare preemptively fast forward to see what happens? It's all repeating so far. I recognize things. None of this is new yet. Strange logic. Gotta kick. Okay, I'm gonna fast forward now, see what happens. Yep, it's going bad. It's going tits up. Crap. Okay. Let's see what you say this time, Mr. Narrator Man. Woman. All right, I warned you. It's time to unleash my secret technique. It's been passed down my kind for generations. Are you ready? I'm just gonna keep repeating this whole conversation, word for word, until you get tired of reading it and leave me alone. After all, you know what they say. Repetition is the younger sister of influence. I haven't heard that, but that has a strong ring of truth to it, quite frankly. Okay. So, we're gonna keep wiggling this time, because maybe there's another decision after that one. I don't remember there being another decision after that one, but that's, we're out of options, people. We are out of options. So, yeah. Maybe I misread. So, in episode 2, I'd said I recalled reading something where the creator of this game said the tokenomics was not a quote real ending, and in the text for this game, it says there are two endings. So maybe the first thing I experienced was I misinterpreted it, and the two endings are the one we've seen a million times, and the tokenomics is official one ending. I don't know. So wiggle our way down there, and aha, aha. Okay, so we have one more decision. I feel fairly confident. If I choose turn back anyways, that it will lead to the bad ending. But let's see. Through nothing short of a miracle, Elora was able to rethink this plan and realize that it was, indeed, not a good idea. Who would have thought? The temptation of the Shiny was very strong, but thankfully common sense was able to triumph in the end. Elora let out a big sigh of relief, super glad that she got cold feet before she decided to jump. The only jumping she'll be doing is back down onto the balcony. After her feet thaw first, of course. Ah, much better. Getting her a feel of the scenery, Elora let the upper half of the body. No! 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 Oh, criminy, fast forward now. So, I'm forced to two possible conclusions. One, the two endings are the tokenomics ending and the terrible ending, which I don't have a good name for. Or two, the tokenomics ending does not count as one of the two official endings, and the other official ending is derived from the bookmark that I have not figured out how to access. It would not be the first time a game has had a bug in it, causing me to lose out on progress. Perhaps the bookmark was supposed to appear in the bookmark list, and it simply didn't. It's a possibility. I don't know how to rectify that. So, basically, I'm just gonna keep going down this tree. Actually, what's this? Can I stop fast-forwarding? What's this do? Previous pages. Oh, I see. I went too fast. I'm assuming that rewinds decisions. Basically, my choice right now is I'm gonna keep going down this tree, choosing everything I remember not having chosen until I get the tokenomics ending again. No lesson learned. We're going to wiggle. We're going to begin Operation Secure the Shiny, which is tokenomics. Okay, so, conclusively, we have exhausted everything about this game. Really? You read through that nonsense again? I gave you the benefit of the doubt the first time. Ending up here could have just been a terrible mistake on your part, but if you're back again, then there's no doubt about it. You must be a weirdo. A total weirdo. Yeah, I could have made a pun from that. But I'm not giving you the satisfaction of my toe puns. Now please don't drag us through that again. If you really want to read that again, just make sure to do it when I'm not around. Jeez. Well, that was worth seeing, I suppose. But, as I was saying prior to that, I believe we have now experienced the totality of this game as it currently exists. Now, I do believe they plan on adding more, fleshing out the story more, adding more chapters, more story, etc., etc. So I will definitely keep my ear to the ground, eye to the wall for those sort of things, toes to the railing, as it were. If, in fact, we were robbed of an ending by a lack of a functional bookmark, please say so in the comments, because I still won't know what to do about that, but I will at least know. And knowing is, I always prefer knowing. So, yeah, that was all of The Chameleon Creator. I'm not sure how long until the next one happens, but until then, there will be other videos. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in those next videos. Signature catchphrase.